Welcome, everyone, and welcome to the Camp Creative Wrap-Up. You might be wondering, what is Camp Creative anyway? Well, I'm glad you asked. For over 10 years, Hallelujah Temple hosted a drama camp unlike anything you've ever seen before. Kids would come in on a Monday, tired and shy and nervous, and be given an opportunity to go from zero to hero in a week. Yes, they would start with nothing, no set, no costumes, not knowing any lines, not knowing any of the music or dance songs, and have to, in 5 days, bond with people they may not know, and then totally and completely build a set, learn lines for a 40-minute play, and then learn 6 to 8 songs and dance routines. It was, how would I describe it, organized chaos. But in the end, when you saw the smiles on their faces and the satisfaction they felt when they received the applause, you know what I'm talking about. Camp Creative is not about finding the next superstar. It's about finding the inner you, the confidence gain, the team building opportunities, the leadership development. It's all transferable to whatever field you choose. So, how do you take an experience that's really designed for kids to collaborate and create something together hands-on and make it work during a time when we're asked to isolate and self-distance? I really don't know. But here's what came of it. A recap of Camp Creative 2020 Inside Out. We looked at a range of emotions that affect our everyday life.
Hi everyone, my name is Angelica Herndon and I'm the acting instructor for Camp Creative. Before you're able to see our acting performance of our monologue piece, I just wanted to explain a little bit of the theme and the idea behind it. It's called The Mask, and masks have been used in the theater history since forever. Ancient theater, when it first began, actually would have the happy face and the sad face. And the actors in these amphitheaters, would be using those masks to cover their face to display those emotions. So if the actor was sad, or if this was a Greek tragedy, they would have the sad mask, and vice versa if it was a happy scene or a comedy. So that's kind of how you get the very famous happy and sad mask whenever you think about theater, or whenever you see theater for the most part. So this monologue is kind of a modern interpretation of people wearing masks. And of course, we all are familiar with wearing masks because we are dealing with a global pandemic. And so this, I just wanted to encourage the students to, obviously, if they had actual masks, to use those real masks, but also kind of pinpoint those things in our lives that we may use as masks to hide our true feelings, to hide our true emotions, and maybe some things that we use as those crutches to kind of deceive people, or to share or to not share aspects of us with others. So I hope you enjoy this. And so this is the students and teachers and faculty and staff, their interpretations of the mask monologue.
I imagine you'd like to know why I'm wearing a mask.
Why I'm wearing this mask?
Why I'm wearing this mask.
Why I'm wearing a mask.
It's really quite simple.
I am wearing no mask because I am a part of the mask.
It's better that way for both of us.
It's better for the both of us.
I don't have to let you see that much of me. And you don't have to know that much of me.
I don't have to let you see that much of me. And you don't have to know more about me. As long as I wear this mask, you'll see what you want to.
You'll accept me. And
as long as I don't let you see me and let you see what I have under this mask.
You'll accept me, I guess. And I can feel as though I belong.
I know. It sounds crazy, but
as long as I wear this mask, you'll see what you want to.
And you don't have to know all about me. But you accept me, and I can feel as though I belong.
You'll accept me. It's crazy, right?
If you just knew, I mean, listen. If I took off this mask and I showed you who I really was, it would be a all alone again.
If you knew just for 1 minute that I'm... If you knew that I was a...
If you knew for just 1 minute that I'm... If you knew that I was... That I...
If you knew that I... That I was a... Listen.
See, I had a friend once who I took my mask off in front of and let her see my true face. And we're not friends anymore.
Now let her see my true face. And guess what? We're not friends no more. The truth is, I have been wearing this mask for decades. See, I have one for almost every occasion. I started wearing it with school, with friends, and...
I have a mask for every occasion. For every purpose. And for everybody I meet. Yes.
Every person I meet, even when I go to school.
And I'm tired of wearing it.
I even have one for church. I know you're thinking I shouldn't be wearing a mask in church. That's the one place I should feel comfortable to take off my mask and let people see me for who I really am.
Oh, you know, I even have one for church. And I know you're like, church, that should be the one place that I could be myself, but...
I might believe that if I thought you did. But you don't.
I'm looking right now, and all I see, is a sea of masks. A sea of masks.
King David was our biblical example. He not only experienced a range of emotions, but expressed them in a variety of ways. He instituted music as part of the temple worship. The sons of Asaph used harps and cymbals and timbrels to accompany their worship. King David's psalms were actually songs, and these songs expressed all kinds of emotion, hope and anger, joy, sorrow, regret, just to name a few. Psalm 63 says, "My soul thirsteth for thee, my flesh longeth for thee in a dry and thirsty land where there is no water." There's something emotional about that. There's so much hope in that. This word to the sixth song says, "Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am weak. O Lord, heal me, for my bones are vexed." Can't you just hear the emotion in that psalm? King David not only sang, but he danced before the Lord with all his might. Getting beyond himself, going beyond what others thought of him, he danced.
My name is Christina Bird, and I am the dance instructor for Camp Creative. I had picked the song, "He Turned It." But before I get into that, I'm gonna tell you how much dance inspires little old me. It helps me, it's my way of escape. It helps me meditate, and it lets me give my all unto God. It is so important to me. And it helps others around me. You know, my young people, you know, it helps them. And also, I picked eternity because things that might look really bad, he can turn around with instant and make it great. Because he turned it, he can make this COVID just go away. But all we have to do is just repent and ask for forgiveness. And he can turn it all around. And he can turn the sickness around. He can turn anything around because only God can do it. Thank you.
Yes, there were times in
With all that's going on with everyone, teens and all, we struggle with a range of emotions. Sadness can be one of them. By using a sad clown as our example, we touched on how everything displayed on the outside may not be a true indicator of what's going on the inside. You may have a happy face but not feel happy. The sad clown, on the other hand, is made up of a sad look, but may very well be happy on the inside. But even sadness, as we learn, has many faces to it. Sorrow, discouragement, misery, or just the many things that might outline sadness. We use art as our canvas to explore sadness and the sadness of emotion.
When a person comes to a theater, they are seated in a seat that doesn't move. And so it is the work of a set designer to provide the greatest visual and audio experience for that person. I'm Reverend Dr. Stead Herndon, and I serve as the set designer for Camp Creative. And everything you see on the stage, except for the actors and what they're wearing, is under the authority of the set designer. And that will include the lighting and the sound. And what I wanted to emphasize to the students this week was just all the different decisions that have to be made and just how you can set moods based upon the colors and the artistry, black and white shadows, and a variety of other different things. So we talked about project management, how you have to manage a budget, how you have to manage different people in terms of their skill sets in order to allow the set to be designed within a particular time frame and within a particular budget. And there are so many different limitations but also advantages to set design, and there it's just gone to from one extreme to the other with special effects, with colors, with movable stage parts, just a variety of different things. So we had a great time. I also wanted to talk to them about creative expressions, and one of their assignments was to draw a sad face clown. And I have my example of my sad face clown that I used just so that they could see that even though the clown may be dressed up, he can have a sad face on the outside, but that doesn't necessarily mean how he feels on the inside. And we talked about masks, we talked about emotions, and also I asked them to think about an emotion and to express that emotion in some creative way. So we tried to move them towards drawing, painting, a variety of different creative expressions as part of Camp Creative this year. And I thought we had a wonderful time, and it was a great experience.
We can't leave our virtual experience without some happy music. Again, we turn to King David as our inspiration. He made a joyful noise unto the Lord, and we weren't singers, but we made a joyful noise anyway. I dedicate this to the campers from Camp Creative. I'm out here on a limb, folks. Today's a new day. But there is no sunshine, nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night. Today's a new day, and where are my blue skies? And where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright. I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain, Holy Ghost, fell from heaven like a shower, and I smile, even though I'm busy, I smile, sure, so I smile, even though I've been here for a while, I smile, smile, it's so hard to look when you've been down, sure.
sure would hate to see you give up now. You look so much better when you smile. I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower. Now, come on, everybody, come on, let's smile. Even though I hurt, see, I smile. I know God is broken, so I smile. Even though I've been here for a while. It's an oh oh. Oh oh oh.
You look so much better when you oh oh oh.
You look so much better when you oh oh oh. You look so much better when you oh oh oh. You look so much better when you oh oh oh. You look so much better when you. Come on, folks, just so much better when you smile.
I hope you enjoy Camp Creative, and I hope that you'll be a part of us next year. I hope we're on the inside again so that we can allow you to create with your hands and your feet and your dance movements together collaboratively. But if we're not, I hope to see you online for another virtual experience. Thank you. God bless. And don't forget to smile.